Hello, everybody. This is AFireInside. ASMR. And today I am going to be playing two spooky games. The first one is Dead by Daylight. And this is a game that you play online. There's four survivors and one killer. So the survivors have to work together to repair generators and also avoiding the killer. And each killer has their own special abilities, and even the survivors have their own special abilities. So it's really fun to pick characters and try to help each other out, because if the killer does get you, they put you on a hook and one of your teammates has to come and unhook you, and then you both have to run away from the killer. You can get different characters when you buy different DLCs. The newest one that I know of was the Silent Hill, which is awesome because I love Silent Hill. But I think there's a newer one now. Okay, and I finally found some survivors to play with. I usually like to talk to the people online, but as you'll see, they usually ignore me. Okay, and the match is finally starting. Sometimes they give you clues at the bottom as to who the killer is. I think when you are a lower level, they tell you who the killer is, but I could be wrong. But I like going in blind anyway, because it's fun to see who the killer is when you first spot them. Now, some killers are super annoying. There's this electric doctor character, and I hate him a lot with a passion. And there's also woman, like an alien that can pop up from the ground. It always scares me, but as you can see, there's a jigsaw doll there, so right away, I know that the killer is going to be the big mask lady. She can also be really annoying because she puts a bear trap on your head. So not only are you trying to hide from the killer, but you have to walk around and trying to find a way to get this thing off your head. But I find this part at the beginning weirdly peaceful. Just looking around, trying not to make much noise, trying to figure out where the killer is. These are the generators that you have to fix. There are five that you have to fix or repair. that's because I have a certain perk on my character. So when somebody repairs a generator, I can see the killer for a couple of seconds, which is really helpful. So a lot of the game is sneaking around, finding the generators, repairing them, and trying to stay out of the killer's sight. So once you get all five generators repaired, then you have to go to one of the three or four or five exits there are. I can never tell because I'm usually so flustered and just trying to find the one. And you have to get the gate open, which of course takes time, and sometimes enough time for the killer to come and find you. When you go to open the gate, it makes noise. So it's a very tense time getting the door open. And once it's open, you only have a certain amount of time before all four survivors have to escape. So, I try my best to stick around as much as I can in case someone gets hooked. But when the killer starts chasing me, I kinda just peace out. I guess you can see her, she comes. I don't really wanna leave yet, but I also don't wanna get hooked. So, that was Dead by Daylight. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope this was informative, but also relaxing to watch. Okay, everybody, next up, the second scary game is called Detention. Detention. And there was actually a warning that I missed in my recording that said there's a lot of violence and gore. So, just so you know, I am going to edit out any jump scares or loud noises because I want this to be spooky, but also relaxing. So this game is a point and click horror game, horror mystery, I would say, based in China. I forget which year. But there are different ghosts and demons that you have to avoid. You have to hold your breath and walk past them, and you have to go through each room and click on anything that you notice. So if you like mystery games where you have to do a lot of inspecting, then this is definitely a game for you. Sound effects, the music really creates an eerie atmosphere. There's a lot of reading though. it's also not a co-op game. It's just single player, I believe, with different chapters. This part was pretty creepy. I'm gonna lower the sound for you guys. Now we are in some school auditorium. And this girl that he meets, she talks a lot, so I'm gonna skip a lot of her dialogue. Scenes like this in the game. The sky looks really cool. When I first saw this, I thought it was pretty freaky. All the blood in the water. Spooky. It kind of gives me a Silent Hill feel. Up and there's a typhoon coming, but when he went to sleep things were a lot different, so I don't know if maybe he entered a different dimension or went back in time. I'm not really sure. This also reminds me of really old PlayStation games. I'm talking about like the very first PlayStation. I think it was when Metal Gear first came out. I remember there was a scene in the game, if I'm thinking of the right one, where you had to use ketchup as blood and confuse one of the guards so that you could sneak out or something like that. It's a lot of fun. We are Anyway,